I welcome on behalf of Reformi Group to all of you, Abhishek, Deepak, and who is a guest, and Karan, Rashid, Nishan, Prashant, and Saurabh. Thank you so much, guys, for joining this audio blog that's a manual testing base and scope. The objective was only because in current scenario, how we are doing a manual testing and what will be the scope of manual testing in future. And there is no any kind of platform. Guys, just keep yourself on mute if you're not speaking, Deepak and Rashid. So, because in current scenario, what you guys are seeing, that what is the scenario of a manual testing nowadays and how manual testing jobs are getting reduced, it doesn't mean that manual testing will not be in scope in future, but very less job are going to produce by the organization for the manual testers, and organizations are expecting that you must have a knowledge in automation. So how we can groom ourselves, how we can cope up with the new technologies, and what are the different things people are doing across the organization. Right now we do not have any kind of platform where we can interact with the people who are across the organization. Like for example, I am working on ABC organization, and one of my friend is working in XYZ corporation, but we do not know how both of us are doing a manual testing, and what are the organization implementation for the manual testing to groom us as a professional. So the objective of doing this audio session is only this. Now I want to know each one of you individually, your experience and your perspective in terms of manual testing. So we should start from Abhishek.
Yes. So as per my opinion, automation testing can help out the manual testing, but it cannot be replaced the manual testing, because nowadays maximum companies are working on agile process or DevOps process, right, model. So in this situations, we are working on rapidly development models. So here, the time constraint will become a major problem. The manual person can do testing faster than the automation testing, because automation will require the test scripts and all frameworks and all things. Instead of this, the manual tester can do it quickly and fastly. So automations can only replace the regression cycle, but it cannot replace the sprint cycle. So from my side, I think if we increase our manual skills more and more, deep and deeper, we will be a safe side. No worry about automation.
Absolutely, Abhishek. And how much experience you have in testing?
Yeah, I have 3.5 years of experience in manual testing.
Okay. Thank you so much, Abhishek, for your point of view. Now, coming to Deepak, same question about your experience. We are not going to ask the organization. It may be confidential for you guys. So just mention your years of experience in testing, and then you can express your view. Yeah, Deepak. Might be Deepak is having some problem. So coming to guest, just speak out your name and okay, he has left. Okay, Chetan, the same question from you, and then your total years of experience in testing.
Yeah, hi, myself Chetan. I'm having total 4 years, 6 months of experience. I'm into the manual testing along with the BFSI domain. So see, like I am working in an organization where we are working in agile safe, means maybe it's a new for you guys, that a new trend in the agile has been I have seen here in the new organization I have joined, which is a safe model. Here we have divided our a big project of a BFSI domain into the trains. There's a background noise. Am I audible?
Yes, Chetan, we can hear you properly.
Okay, no problem. I thought there is some problem. Okay, so this is about my experience. See, as far as the concern that right now the jobs are going, jobs about the manual testing, I have seen that people are working into the manual testing, but they don't know about exactly what is the manual testing and the procedures and used into the manual testing, the methodology is used into the manual testing, and also that if you are working in a domain, then means people are not aware. So thing is that to survive in not in IT in every field, we need to groom ourselves properly, timely, and we need to adopt the changes into the market.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Okay, so this is all about from me.
Okay, thank you so much, Chetan, for your view. Now coming to Deepak again. Deepak, what is your perspective and your total years of experience in a manual testing? I guess Deepak is still not able to hear. Okay, Karan, the same question from you. Karan, can you hear us? Okay, Rashid, same question from you again. Rashid, can you hear us? Okay, Nishant. So, Rashid, can you speak or you can type? We will narrate whatever you have typed. In the meantime, I'm going to Nishant. Nishant, what is your view for this and your years of experience?
Hello, hi.
Hello.
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Hello.
Yes.
Nishant, actually, I have a total experience of 1.6 years in manual testing, and currently I'm working QL2 Software in a private limited. As my opinion, I think is automation testing is nowadays much better than the manual testing, and I am totally agree with Abhishek on point of views. That's all.
Okay, and. You think the same way like Abhishek expressed, right?
Yes.
Okay. Saurabh, the same question from you. Nishant, just keep yourself on mute because others.
Hi all. I have been working in manual testing for 3.6 years, and what my experience and views about manual testing was automation time. If you are working in product-based company, so there might not be you are using for automation, or there are so many changes or regression that you can go for manual. But manual testing is very vast and is on big. But if you think about service-based company, like they have to deal with client, and if the client as the technology is changing randomly and the client is asking for automation and whatever the skills, if we ask, then automatically demand for that skill is becoming higher for that. So in that case, we do have to upgrade ourselves on the basis of skills and what. That's my that's my view.
True, very true. Thank you so much, Saurabh. Now, coming to Rashid again, because he was expressing something, he couldn't. Saurabh, just keep yourself on mute. Yeah, Rashid. Okay, Deepak? No, Rashid, we cannot hear you. Okay, guys, we have prepared on the basis of, we have, as you know, that Refermi Group is now increased with a good number of members in Refermi Group. Like, we are on a Google group, more than 5,000 professionals by QA, only 5,000 QA professionals has been associated with Refermi Group. And on a LinkedIn, we have more than 4,900 connections. On Facebook, we have 2,000 plus. Another 3,000 connections are there. So on the basis of a few parameters, we have consulted with professionals who are having a 11 or 15 years of experience who are having a good knowledge in their domain and in expertise in their areas. On the basis of the judgment, we have created one presentation, you can say, or a growth of a manual tester. So we can see here, like, if we are in manual testing, right? So we have three options, like you guys have narrated very well. Either you can go for as a test coordinator or test lead or white box tester or as a mobile or web services or security analyst, right? Apart from that, there is another chances, like Chetan has mentioned, if you are an expert in any domain, then you can enter yourself as a domain expertise. We will discuss why companies are asking for manual for automation nowadays, but what actually happens when you go for an interview. So we will discuss that point as well, and we'll get to know your view on that, on the same thing. So if I am taking the first one as a test coordinator or the test lead at the years of experience, 5 to 8 years, because up to 0 to 3 years, or in some organizations 0 to 5 years, you work as an individual contributor or as a team, then you get a lead role or get a team to lead the position. And then it is required that you must have a CST or CSQA or ISTQB advanced certified. Up to 0 to 3 year organizations, or it is expected that you must have ISTQB certifications, which is a milestone that is considered to a testing fee or testing platform. After test lead, you can go for a test manager, then transformation lead, and then as a business strategy or a customer expert leader or in IT management role, that is up to, I should say that it is 18 plus years of experience people. If you are opting as a domain expert, then you can be a business analyst or you can be a senior business analyst in the same way. Rather, after senior business analyst, again the role will merge to a business strategist. If you are going as a white box tester and you are not opting any automation tool, then what is alternate for me to not opting any automation tool for me to learn for? Then in the white box tester, you could be a senior automated architect, then principal or automation architect, and then few technologies like SaaS or cloud are there which you can learn where you are not supposed to work as automation professional. Then another chunk which is automation. We should discuss here because that is also part of your testing. So if you are automation expert, you can go for automation architect, then senior automation architect, then principal automation architect, and then SaaS or automation. Here, sorry, the white box tester also has the same kind of thing, right? And as a manual tester, I have another option that I can opt my skill, or I can change my skill to mobile testing, which is one of the fastest growing market nowadays, right? And then I can be a test manager in the same thing, and again transformation lead and business strategies or customer expert leader or in IT management role. So this we have created on the basis of experience people, or on the basis of people who have coordinated. And we have also mentioned about what kind of certification and what kind of things you can learn if you want to grow in automation, like Selenium, JMeter, SOAP UI, RFT, LoadRunner, Kafka, any of the things. Now coming to the question, why companies are very much excited or very much interested to hire automation expert rather than manual testers or rather than manual professionals. So what you guys think about this? Any of you can participate in this?
Can you please repeat your question again?
Sure. My question was that why companies are asking automation expert or that you must aware or you must know about the automation instead of manual testers, and why the jobs are getting reduced in manual testing nowadays. What is the reason behind that?
The main reason behind that is means our country means participating in IT industry since a long time. And if you look for big projects into the big companies, they are almost, many kind of requirements or many kind of modules, they have been freezed at there. Mm-hmm. Means there is only a maintenance kind of thing.
Correct.
So they don't want to, share their profit in terms of salaries to the person who is just performing a manual testing, which is not, in which they are not going to change anything.
Right.
So this is the main reason. And further, in each and every application, either it's new or the old, there is a regression which we need to perform. Mm-hmm. So basically and majorly, companies are looking for the automation tester not in the fresh module, but into the regression module.
Okay.
So this is the main reason.
Okay. Thank you, Chetan, for your statement. And what other guys think? Abhishek, Deepak, Rashid, Nishant, Rakesh or Saurabh? What do you guys think? Why companies are going towards manual, towards automation?
Yes, I also agree with that. Companies are looking for automation for a stable project or product.
Mm-hmm.
But and also company wants to a person who can have both that.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So some of the companies are looking for a guys who have experience in manual testing and also have a good knowledge or working knowledge on automation. So according to the requirement of the project, they will switch a person, same person, into different profile.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So nowadays companies are a person who have not only the one skill, more than one skill, so it will be beneficial for the company.
Mm-hmm.
Because at the end, if a project is a long-term project, like 5-year, 10-year project, if the company have, when the company is hiring for those kind of projects, so they will maybe think that we can hire a person who can initially for 2 to 3 months, we can perform manual testing. And after that, because for automation process, automation script, the product knowledge or the project knowledge is very important to write out the effective test script, right? So with the same guy who have done manual testing for the same project for 2 to 3 years,
mm-hmm.
company will maybe ask the same person to write out the automation script for the same project.
Mm-hmm.
So he will be the efficient and right persons to write down the automation script for the project who will go for last in a maintenance stage. So that is why the company are looking for a person who can fulfill the requirement of manual tester when it is requirement, and who can also fulfill the requirement of automation tester whenever required. I think this is the reason, maybe.
Right, Abhishek. Absolutely. So Deepak, Rashid, Nishant and Rakesh or Saurabh, what do you guys think? Okay, but guys, what happens in actual scenario that companies take interview on automation, but when we go inside the organization, what happens actually? They give you a task to do on manual testing. They take a work on a manual testing, although they have hired the professionals on automation, but actually in 90% of the cases people involve only a manual testing. So the entry criteria for interview or switching the job, that you should be aware with few concepts, right? Few concepts in automation, like you should know about the basics of Java if you have you are having 1 to 3 years of experience. After that, they expect that you should be expert in any of the tool. And after 7 to 8 years, nowadays companies are changing and they are demanding that you should be expert in more than one tool in automation. But up to 1 to 3 years, they are expecting that you should aware about the Java concept. Now coming to manual testing, how we can survive in manual testing. Either you can, if you are in the same project or in the same organization, so you should make yourself as an SME, which is subject matter expertise. Do some certifications in manual testing like ISTQB Foundation, ISTQB Advanced, then CST you can do, then you can go for a CSQA, which is a quality analyst certification and consider as one of the good certificates. then you can go for Agile certification two ways. Either you can go for a CSM, that is an open book certification, or you can go for Agile certificate, which is given by ISTQB. Then after that, if you want to develop your career or grow your career in manual testing only, then as a lead, you can go for a certifications like TQM, that's a test quality management, and you can go for some PMP certification, or you can go for a PRINCE 2, or these certifications will add an advantage in you if you want to be in manual testing. If you want to grow your career as a business analyst, then you can do a certification for a business analyst given by one of the organizations in the US. I don't remember the name exactly, but it is a business analyst certificate that you can do. For a banking domain, you can start from learning or doing a certification from NSC, from airlines. You can do a certification from airline domain, from hospitality or education. There's something different from insurance. You have different agencies which provide certification in your insurance, like the companies, NIT and other companies are working in these domains, right? So if you want to grow your career and want to prove yourself, no, manual testing is still alive, and we will make our career and prove to others that yes, manual testing cannot be omitted or cannot be skipped by automation, then these are the areas where you can prove yourself by doing these certifications. And believe me, in a refurbing group, we have seen that still people doesn't have a good knowledge in a manual testing. I mean, we are surprised when we do a kind of normal discussion with the people, so they do not know what is the RT. Some basic things I am telling, like they are not aware what is the RTM, what is how to prepare a test plan, what is the difference between test plan and test strategy. Everyone is having a bookish knowledge, right? Important thing is that we should get involved and we should learn from the prospective how organizations are working. Few organizations doesn't have a test strategy, they work only on test plan, right? So these are the area if you want to be in a manual testing, which cannot be omitted in any era, I should say. So you can do these certifications and you can participate in your organization and become a subject matter expertise or expert in your area. Then you can prove, yes, I haven't learned automation, but I have proven myself in manual testing. Now coming to another question which we have decided, Kanika, you have just joined, so welcome to this audio blog forum. Till now we have discussed how manual testing is going to down and how we can escape ourselves and what are the ways and how we are doing manual testing. Apart from that, we have discussed why automation is required nowadays and demanded by the organization. Now, coming to the next question which I have raised initially, how you guys are doing it differently in a manual testing? Any tool you are using or how performing your organization? Here, I'm not expecting that you should disclose any confidential information, but in general, you can discuss here. So let's start with any of you guys who wants to participate. Abhishek, Chetan, Deepak, Kanika, Rashid, Vishant, Rahul, Rakesh, or Saurabh. How you guys are doing a manual testing? What is your view that this should be done in this way and this is not followed exactly?
See, I would like to add here that at the very first of point that when we start our testing or they start our the cycle, we receive the document.
Mm-hmm.
In my current organization and previous organization, I have observed that people don't go into the depth. Means whatever they have written, just means if they have written just 2 plus 2 is 4, then they just look for that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Or just they check 3 plus 1 is 4, but they don't check things like that, the corner cases kind of thing, or the means in manual testing we are not trying to think out of the box.
Mm-hmm.
Means we can think that 5 minus 1 could also be a 4.
Absolutely.
So we need to think out of the box. When you think out of the box and you came out with the defect or the scenario which is out of the box, you are automatically recognized in our respective organization.
Mm-hmm.
So to be recognized, to be survive, or to prove yourself, you need to be prove. You need to showcase your work.
Absolutely.
Only through your work you can only be recognized. You can only be survived. Either you in manual testing or either in automation testing.
Absolutely.
For survival, you think you need to go beyond the boundaries.
Absolutely. And that is the reason in any organization, only few person, rather I should say, only 2 to 5% of the people are getting higher rating in manual testing as well, because they think out of the boundary. Yes, absolutely, very well said. Like, if it is written 2 plus 2 is equal to 4, then why we don't think that 2.5 plus 1.5 can be equal to also 4, right? So that is another way. Why we are not thinking the business from business perspective, how the customer is feeling about this product, how the customer is going to use this product. What is the ways that customer can feel or customer can suffer if the product is not going to fulfill his or her requirement? How the main objective of as a manual tester, how you can crack the application, how you can break the application, right? So how many people we are going to perform like that way, or how many people we have a attitude by that way, or with this attitude we go to the organization and test the application? Very less, I suppose.
To add this, I would like to say that we think like that we are working just and we just got salary. But if we start thinking that whatever project or whatever application we are working, it's our own application.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll itself start thinking beyond the boundaries.
Mm-hmm.
Somewhere we are not itself giving a feel in our work that we are working.
Mm-hmm.
We just feel that we need to go office, we need to check out at the time. Means our card should be punched, our timesheet should be filled, and at the last day of the month, our salary should be credited. Just we think about that. But if we start thinking towards and means with respect to the client, and we think that this is our own application, we will start itself getting into the depth.
Absolutely.
So this is also a major reason that we don't love our work as well.
Indeed. Thank you, Chetan. And Kanika, you just joined, so you would like to participate in this? Kanika, can you hear us? Okay, Rashid, you haven't spoken anything in this forum. Nishant and Rahul or Rakesh, you would like to share something on this? What is your approach in your organization and how we should approach exactly? Abhishek?
What I would like to say is when you are going to manually test an application,
mm-hmm.
people are expecting document from a business analyst or expecting document from a customer or some client.
Mm-hmm.
Don't expect any document first. First of all, when you are getting an application, you anyways know about the username, password, mm-hmm. and the application login URL.
Mm-hmm.
My approach of manual testing is, first I would like to explore the website on my own. So that as an end user, will access the application from my point of view. So I...
Rakesh, your voice, okay. Yeah, go ahead.
When I'm having my own observations,
mm-hmm.
so once the document is in the picture, that means from the business analyst or from someone,
mm-hmm.
I would like to map my observations with that. And if any observations are not matching with that, then I can have a call with that so that we can go ahead with out of boundaries or go ahead with the corner concepts. I think exploratory testing helps before going with any document for me.
Yes, very true. And even interview question, this is one of the question they ask, that if you do not have a document, then how you will proceed. So that is a one way to proceed for testing if you do not have any document, right? Thank you so much, Rakesh, for your view on this. Abhishek, you were saying something on that?
I want to add one point in the same, that we should not think in a way that we find the defect as much as possible. We also known as the quality analysis. Quality analysis, for my opinion, is that who are delivering the quality product.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So if you found 100 of the bugs in your application, mm-hmm. but it fails to fulfill the user requirement in the market.
Mm-hmm.
So no matter how many bugs, how many defects you found, but we should think about the overall quality of our application.
You're
how
right.
it will be, how it will be play a role in market for user perspective view. We should think about 360 degree view.
Mm-hmm.
Not only focus on the finding the bug. It is our core job. We should do, but apart from that, we also think about other kind of testing, right? Performance testing. Whether we don't have any scope of performance testing, but we can test, we can observe by manually as well. Like if we are loading an application, it is too much time taking, but it is loading. For ourselves, it is not a bug, so this is loading, but it is taking too much time. So do you think that user will be stay on your application if it is taking too much time? This is a simple example. In the same way, you should think about, other than the functional, we should think about the non-functional things as well. Second thing, what we always learn from the mistake, right? So mm-hmm. whatever we did mistake in our last or previous project in previous company, we should think about it, what we have done wrong, how can we be better much, and how can we become ourselves good and good, so that in future project we can do smoothly and efficiently.
Very true, very true, very true, Abhishek. Okay, Kanika, you were saying something?
Yeah, hello.
Yeah, Kanika, we can hear you.
Yeah, actually my point is, as a manual tester in my organization, we almost got busy in the functional testing only.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Nobody is bothered about any type of testing, nobody is bothering about any out of the box thinking and all that. So means, like, in my organization we don't bother any of the, like, other out of the box thinking.
Mm-hmm.
And this usually halt as a manual tester. I only focus on functional testing.
Mm-hmm.
This should not be done, right?
Mm-hmm.
We always focus on other types of testing also in manual point of view.
Mm-hmm.
In my organization, we have two teams, like one is automation and one is manual. Mm-hmm. Manual has some ad hoc tasks always. We have some documents from product, and we have to find the functionality of that flow only, and then we go with the releases. But this should not be done.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is my main concern, because I haven't tried any other type of testing other than functional in my whole career. So this is the main point I just want to share.
Okay, okay. Thank you, Kanika, for your expression. And Ajay, you have just joined, so you would like to contribute something?
Yeah, actually I just want to contribute, and I just want to know ki in manual testing, what are the ways, different types of ways we can we can implement, so that I just want to know from you and other people also, so that we can.
Okay, Kanika, we have covered that part already, and we have shown that how manual tester can proceed. But before end of this session, we will again show you how a manual tester can grow in his or her organization, and what are the different roles or different prospects for a manual tester would be in future.
Yeah.
Right. So Ajay, you were saying something. Yes, Kanika, just keep yourself on mute, please. Yeah, Ajay. Ajay, we are not able to hear you. Uh, Ajay, if you are not able to, I mean, there is some problem in your audio, then you can type and we will narrate on your behalf. Okay, so we have discussed about this presentation, like how a manual tester can go, like if we will see there are two things are here, like the manual testing and automation, right? So we are talking about the manual, then manual has a three scope which can be go further. What is your test coordinator or test lead, or another is your as a white box tester, and next is your mobile or dev mobile application or web service, or as a security analyst, and that start usually on 5 to 8 years of experience, and 0 to 3 years, and in some organizations 0 to 5 years. But how we can prove in a manual testing here? At this experience, you can do ISTQB, you can foundation, you can do Agile certification, you can do CST, which is a foundation. Then at experience of 5 to 8 years, you must have to go for ISTQB part. Advanced level, then CST or CSQA, you can go and do a certification in DB database or in Unix. You can do, you can learn the testing processes are there, how they are going to implement. Then after test coordinator, you can go for a test manager or test lead, where you are involved with the appraisal. Then you can do a certification like PMP, PRINCE2 or TQM. These certifications are available in the market, right? Then after test manager, test coordinator, you can go for a transformation lead. And after that, at 18 plus years of experience, you grow as a business strategist or customer expertise leader or IT management role you go on, right? Where you need to know the sales and everything. Now as a white box tester, you can develop your career as a senior automation architect. This, just note it down, this is an architect, not as an automation tester. Then you can be a principal automation architect, then you can go for a SaaS or cloud automation, and again this role is going to merge here because this is the final role for any IT organization. The third step, if you are going for a mobile or web services or security analyst, then again you can grow your career as a test manager, and this will lead to the same. Apart from that, if you want, you do not want to be in technical, then you can be a SME, that's a subject matter expertise, then you can be a domain expert, then business analyst, and then senior business analyst, and after that you can be a business strategist, right? If you are going at, as automation, so you can be automation architect, then senior automation architect, and the same thing will happen. Now the important, like we have discussed about the certification already, which you can do. If you want to be a, you want to develop your career as a business analyst, then what kind of certifications are required that we have discussed, right? Now one point which is discussed here, which I think we should not omit. You guys have mentioned about exploratory testing, and you guys have mentioned about the thing that how we should approach for the testing. Normally what happens in a manual testing that we do not approach to a developers, right? If you find any defect, just approach to a developer. If the developer is sitting in the same organization, go and initially it will be a little bit tough, but once you will create your rapport, once you will create your presence in the project, so you can ask to the developer that he or she can show you the code, then you can do a kind of analysis how codes are flowing, how the data are going from one state to another state, then you can develop your test cases as well, and you can see how the why the defects are coming, right? So you can do analysis on the coding side, which doesn't require any kind of automation learning. Second thing is that you can ask your manager or you can ask your lead that how this product is working in, if it is a maintenance or if it is a something new change in the existing product. So you can ask your manager that how it is going to, or how the people are using in a real environment, if you can see that, or how UAT, that's the user acceptance testing, is going on, how people are doing, right? By that way you will generate or you will create some kind of business approach for the for the application. By doing that, you will see that how the customer is going to associate with your product which you are going to test. So these are the ways by which you can enhance your skills on a manual testing side. Yes, we are agree that nowadays organizations are asking for automation, and slowly in 2 to 3 years, as the current scenario is going on, that the manual testing market will go down. But it doesn't mean that manual testers will not be there. And anyhow, we have to switch or we have to learn automation by any ways, right? But these are the things which we can do right now to be in the manual testing profession, right? So any view you guys would like to share, like Abhishek, Ajay, Chetan, Kanika, Nishan, and Rakesh? Yes.
I would like to add one thing, like we discussed about the certifications.
Mm-hmm.
So many of the people, even into the manual testing, they are working, but we don't think to go even for foundation level of ISTQB.
Right, right.
And start working in 5,000 of our group. Many people are working into the BFSI domain, mm-hmm. but we never think about that, doing that certifications.
Mm-hmm.
So. You know that even I am telling you my personal experience that I recently joined a company
mm-hmm.
and I got three offers
mm-hmm.
and there I bought on the basis of my certificate.
Chetan, I am sorry to interrupt you, but your voice is a little bit up and down.
Am I audible now?
Yes, perfect.
Okay. So I'm telling you my personal experience that I've seen that certificates are given weightage somewhere.
Yes.
Means in resume shortlisting or even in the negotiation of your salary discussion.
Right.
So we should focus towards not on means we see we are working somewhere we have the knowledge, but to segregate ourselves from the bunch of the people, we need to have something different. So exact, if I would like to say that the certifications are the thing which segregate from the bunch of the people.
Mm-hmm.
So this is my point of view. Even in like refer me initiated a ISTQB certification, I have seen that lot of people have done.
Whenever
if I would like to say, if let us suppose I need to shortlist a resume and I need to look for a person who have 1 or 2 years of experience.
Right.
And I have 10 resumes, so I would like to look who have done the ISTQB foundation level. Somewhere right. It defines the level of the knowledge of that person.
Yes, and understanding as well. Absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely.
So this is my point. And even sometimes I feel in my organization and my previous organization as well, I would like to add one thing. See, we are into the testing
mm-hmm.
and we are the goalkeeper section.
Mm-hmm.
And I have seen that sometimes a defect have been missed by us
mm-hmm.
and it came at any stage that it's a general practice in testing.
Mm-hmm.
But we don't do the RCO of the same.
Mm-hmm.
Means if any defect occurs even in our testing life cycle or on production or any QA
mm-hmm.
or even of other testers as well, if we start doing that analysis how that defect is occurring, so it will improve our understanding of our product or the project we are testing. It will improve the thinking of way to test that. So these are the 2 points which I would like to add.
Right. Thank you, Chetan. Yes, Nishant, you were saying something.
Hi.
Hi.
Yeah, my question is there any certification available for test automation?
Test automation, there are so many. I mean, you can go and check on the net, but here we are discussing about the manual testing. So, automation,
okay.
UTP, you can check with the HP website, mm-hmm. Roadrunner, they have a certification. And Selenium, I'm not sure, but for Selenium you can do a Java certification. So many things are available.
Okay.
Like,
so ISTQB is mandatory for a manual tester.
No. Now coming to your question.
Hello.
Yes, Nishant. Coming to your question. Yes. Why ISTQB is mandatory or why it is not? One question I would like to ask. Yes. Anything else, Nishant? You want to say?
No.
Okay. So one question. Okay, thank you. one question, anyone else want to say something or should we express? Okay. So one question just to you guys, in your vicinity, why you go to any service center? Suppose your car is or your bike is broken down. So why you prefer to go to a service center instead of consulting with any local mechanic? The mechanic is also expert and he is charging very less, but service center charge you very high. Why the service center are running? Because the reason is they are certified. Now here is the difference, like Chetan has mentioned, and what we have feel, if certifications are mentioned in your resume, and that is the first criteria to select your resume or reject anyone's resume, and that creates a difference between a professionals from among or in a purchase of 10 to 15 resume. Do you think that if today any organization opens manual testing walk-in or opening for 1 to 5 years of experience, then how many resumes they will get for any location, right? If I'm talking about for Gurgaon location, they are any organization ABC has opening up for manual testing up to 1 to 5 years. So what do you think? How many resumes should HR will get? Any rough idea? Abhishek, Chetan, Kanika, Nishant, Rakesh.
Sorry, your voice was dropped.
Okay, my question was, suppose there is an opening in any organization up to 1 to 5 years of experience in manual testing, and person should know good knowledge having a manual testing only. So what do you think, how many resume the HR will get in the span of 7 days?
Thousands.
Okay, Rakesh?
Yeah, even I would like to say the same.
Okay, Kanika?
Thousands of.
Okay, Ajay, you can type because we are not able to hear you. Okay, Chetan?
I would like to say that you cannot count. Even if you post an opening just for 1 to 5 years in our group, I think in 1 to 5 years of band, out of 5,000, somewhere 3,500 people will be there.
Yes.
And I expect more than 2,500 itself from our group.
Mm-hmm.
So I believe that means manual testing of 1 to 5 years, numerous of people you can receive the CV.
Yes.
You cannot define in means in terms of numbers.
Right, right. So guys, just keep yourself on mute. Kanita, please. Okay. So we are talking about the numbers. So approximately 1,000 resumes will come. So do you think that HR is going to screen all 1,000 resumes one by one or call 1,000 people one by one? No, obviously not. Right? So what is the first criteria to select the person? First, they will see how many certifications a person is having. Second, the HR will see how many organizations they have worked upon, how many number of switches are there, which organizations they have worked upon, then which kind of product or project they have worked upon, because they have a specific requirement. For example, this opening is for insurance domain or airlines domain or banking domain, so they have worked on similar kind of domain or not. Then they will see where the participant or where the resume sender is residing, what is his current location, right? Then the person will HR will see how many award has been got by the person in his or her organization. So these are the few 6 criteria by which the shortlisted has been done. And out of 1,000 resume, I am sure that at least only 200 resumes will be fulfilling the criteria which has been set by the HR. So the first rejection or selection criteria is your certification. And that is the reason certification is very important. If you want to be in manual or you want to be in automation, right? Anywhere. Now, coming to the point, we are not here to do any kind of advertisement or any kind of spread for the Republic group. because this forum is just for a creator to know the perspective and how we can do best in a manual testing. Just want to add that we have affiliation with ISTQB, where if you want to give ISTQB certification, you can get a discount. We have started multiple workshops on a domain as well, where you can learn airline, BFSI, you can learn insurance, you can learn education, you can learn any of the domain you can pick, we have expert on that. So you can register on that workshop and go and learn. Right? Important is how much willing we are to groom ourselves, because if we are looking for a change or looking for a better career option, then these things are mandatory nowadays. Our next option is just go for automation. But if you want to grow your career in manual testing, then you have to do a certification and you have to groom yourself. And ISTQB Foundation is a basic certification to groom or to learn the things or give you a kind of confidence, right? And that is the reason certifications are important. So I hope approximately 1 hour has been passed and we have discussed so many things today in our first blog, that is a first audio blog about manual testing ways and scope and how we can groom. So we are closing this session here. Anyone would like to add here something? And I hope all of you are from referral group only, right?
Yes, right.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, so anything?
Yeah, out of the topic, I would like to ask one question. Can I ask?
Yeah, sure, please.
Okay, we had Refer Me group, QA group, right? I think recently they have created Google Drive, right?
Mm-hmm.
But how to access, get access to that Google Drive?
Okay, Rakesh, this is out of this audio blog question, but since you have asked, so we need to answer. We are not providing access to the people who are just asking for the access on a Google Drive. Reason behind, because we want every one of you to do some effort to find out one unique document which we can upload. Obviously not confidential anywhere. And that can be accessed by anyone who are having access. Objective behind doing this precondition, reason, because if you will search for a unique document, you will do some Googling or you will search for the document and then you will get to know about new things what can be learned, right? So that is the only objective to do this kind of precondition. If you are sharing any document with us, we will give you access on a shared drive. And people who got the access, they have done it before. And we have multiple kind of documents are there about Unix, Selenium, JMeter, manual testing, database. And then we have a domain documents are there. So a lot of documents are there which you can get access.
Okay, to which email I need to share that unique document?
On contact@referralgroup.com.
Yeah, sounds good.
Yeah. Okay, guys, so we will post this audio on our YouTube channel. You can go and watch it and refer to your friend. If anyone is looking for a manual testing, how they can survive. Apart from that, we will send a mail on a referral group. You can just drop your comment on the same mail. You can reply on that. So next time when we will do another audio blog on the next week, so more and more people will participate on the same, right? Before closing the session, again, I am asking to all of you, anything you would like to add?
Finally, I would like to say that just be expert on your field, whether you want to stay in manual or whether you want to in automations or any other field.
Mm-hmm.
Just try, do hard work, prove yourself and try to be a unique resource of your field. You will be always be valuable. No one
absolutely
can replace you.
Absolutely. Very well said, Abhishek. Very well said. Guys, just remember the day when you have entered first time in the organization, how you have felt on that day. You have a dream by which you went to the organization. You have a dream that, yes, I will prove myself. So passionate about that and prove yourself, yes, you are different from others. When you will go with the same passion every day, believe me, you will prove yourself. Go with the passion that today I will crack the application by any hand. Right? So these are the ways. So thank you so much, guys, for joining this session. I'm closing it here. Anything you want to say something, you can. Okay, Chetan and Kanika, you want to say something?
I would like to add and emphasize again that you people who are available in this session and people on the group who have not joined the session and going to look into the YouTube channel, that please try to go for the certifications.
Yeah.
Whatever field or whatever application or whatever domain you in which you are, just please go for the certifications respective technology or the domain.
Right. So Kanika, you want to say something?
Yeah. You just mentioned ISPQP certification, right?
Mm-hmm.
Correct. Yeah. I just want to know, ki, do we have this facility for referring to site ki we can do this certification or tutorials and all that?
Yes.
ISPQP?
Yes, we provide the tutorial and we have a demo also tomorrow at 9 o'clock. So you can drop a mail and we will reply you how you can join the demo. Second thing is that
tomorrow at 9.
Yes, it is not necessary that you do from a referral group only. You do the certification from anywhere. We are not forcing anyone that no referral group.
No, I didn't want to say that you are forcing, but I am just following the referral group from last 1 month or 2 months.
Kanika, your voice is very low here.
Hello?
Yes. Kanika, please speak louder because again your voice is very low.
Hello?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, it's now audible.
Yeah. I just want to say ki I'm not saying ki you are forcing or anything else. It's my concern. I'm following this group from last 2 months.
Mm-hmm.
So it will be very easy for me to do the certification from this group only. So that's why I'm asking you ki when you have you any batches for this also.
Mm-hmm. So
for ISPQB.
Okay. Just drop a mail on contact at directreferralgroup.com and we will revert you how you can log in. Right. Fine. Okay.
Thank you.
So thank you so much, guys, again for joining, and please do not forget to put your comment on YouTube channel and on a referral group where we will post this so that other people who are seeking for help, and referral group is their only objective to help each one of member who has joined us, because everyone is looking for help nowadays, so they will be aware only when we will push those guys who has joined today's audio. So please put your comment on YouTube channel, please put your comment on Google group when we will post a mail, so next time more and more people can join and get benefit from this audio blog. Right?
Sure.
Okay, sure. Okay.
Thank you so much, Abhishek. Thanks a lot, Chetan. Thank you, Kanika. Thank you, Nishan. Thank you, Ajay, for joining. Enjoy the weekend. Take care and be expert in your career, in your project, and prove yourself, yes, I am something. You cannot ignore me. Right?
Right, right.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, guys.
Yes, absolutely right.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Same to you. Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you. Thank you.